10 tugboats pushing and pulling the run-aground ship, along with help from the high tide, managed to partially free the vessel, but there's no word on when it will be completely freed. 7 days ago, the skyscraper-sized Ever Given got stuck in the crucial waterway, something that's never happened in the 150-year history of the Suez Canal, one of the most strategic waterways in the world.
Like the Panama Canal is, it carries about 12% of world trade each year. That's roughly, in monetary terms, about $1.1 trillion worth of cargo passed through the Suez Canal, about $3 billion every day. About 18,000 ships use it a year, it's about 50 ships a day, so it's absolutely key. So you get something like this, a ship effectively blocking it, you actually really are blocking that trade flow.
The massive traffic jam holding up nearly 400 ships, which contain everything from furniture to coffee to car parts. The delay is costing companies billions of dollars, a cost they'll likely pass on to the consumer.
The fact that now we're seeing a backlog could have ripple effects here in the U.S.
It's also affecting the flow of the world's crude oil. Nearly 10% is transported through the canal, and that backlog could affect the cost of gas at U.S. pumps.
At some point this summer, we could see a national average of $3 a gallon.
The impact is being felt in Europe since the ship blocked the crucial east-west waterway connecting Europe and Asia. The alternative route takes vessels nearly 2 weeks to sail all the way around Africa.
Container ships, tankers are not delivering food, fuel, manufactured goods to Europe, and goods are not being exported from Europe to the Far East. And this is going to have a massive impact on production, on availability of goods in Europe and in Asia.
One expert compared what will happen next to taking a cork out of a bottle. Once it's opened, vessels will be arriving at global ports at the same time and will have to wait in line once again. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.